The Supreme Master Qinghai International Association Appreciation News from the United States. The International Extremity Project, IEP, is a non-profit medical initiative that provides surgical correction for lower extremity deformities to underprivileged individuals in OLAC, also known as Vietnam, and Namibia. The Nobel Project was founded by podiatric surgeons Dr. Bruce Leonard and Dr. Jeffrey Spankel. On July 15, 2018, our association members from San Jose, California, USA, presented a $50,000 check from Supreme Master Qinghai to the IEP. Our beloved master gave the monetary gift in heartfelt love and gratitude for all involved, and best wishes for their further mission.
Well, actually, this is a very moving gift. It's certainly one of the best donations that we've had in our 20 years of service, and I want to personally thank Master Qinghai for the thoughtfulness.
Dr. Leonard wrote a thank you letter to Supreme Master Qinghai on behalf of IEP and also expressed his appreciation during the check presentation.
I would like to thank the Supreme Master for this very generous donation. And she must realize that this goes so far in helping all the children that we operate on, and every footstep they take for decades to come will be changed because of the help that she's given to the children.
Dr. Leonard and Dr. Spanko, along with IEP's mission coordinator Henry Duval Saint, were also presented with a collection of Master's publications, CDs, and vegan chocolates. Our warm respect and earnest thanks to Dr. Bruce Leonard, Dr. Jeffrey Spanko, Henry Duval Saint, and all the professionals volunteering their time and expertise as part of the International Extremity Project. May you continue your precious work of helping others less fortunate in heaven's blessings. Supreme Master Qinghai is deeply grateful to the beloved God for all the financial help, comfort and support to the afflicted and needy, and or any good cause over the years. As a humble vessel for His, compassion and love towards His precious children.
Airlines Fly 8 for Kerala floods victims. Air India, Jet Airways, Air Vistara, Qatar Airways, and Emirates Sky Cargo delivered relief goods for free to the victims of serious flooding in Kerala, a province in India. For a period of time, Cochin International Airport and train services in Kerala were shut down. Therefore, delivery of relief aid became critically important. Among domestic airlines, Air India and Jet Airways have waived freight charges for relief items being sent to Kerala, while Air Vistara joined with several NGOs to fly doctors, nurses, and supplies to the flooded areas.
Dubai-based cargo airline Emirates Sky Cargo pledged to transport more than 175 metric tons of relief goods, including life-saving boats, blankets, and dry food items,
which have been donated by various businesses and organizations in the United Arab Emirates. Qatar's flag carrier, Qatar Airways, also delivered 50 metric tons of needed items to the flood victims. Our heartfelt gratitude, all airlines that have helped our sisters and brothers in their time of need. May life soon return to normal for all flood-affected individuals in the grace of the Providence.
Model with Down syndrome graces runway in New York. Mariana Vila is the first Spanish woman with Down syndrome to model at New York Fashion Week, which is one of the most esteemed events in the fashion industry. Miss Avila wore dazzling evening gowns and met with some top fashion magazines, as well as different modeling agencies. The 21-year-old model received an invitation to the glamorous event from renowned designer Talisha White and 14-year-old model Kenzie Dugmore, who is committed to helping people with Down syndrome. Miss Avila said, "Everyone is different, but we can be equals. We should strive to be unique and to chase our dreams and keep going. Like I do. Seeing you fulfilling your dreams is so inspiring, Mariana Vila. May many shining opportunities come your way as you continue enhancing our world with your beautiful presence."
Californian lawmaker proposes plant-based resolution. California, United States Assembly Member The Honorable Ash Kalra has put forward Resolution ACR 279, which encourages residents to transition to the sustainable and healthy plant-based diet. Assemblyman Kalra stated, as the world's population continues to grow, California should continue to demonstrate how the world's population can reduce its impact on the environment. A growing amount of research has demonstrated the health, environmental, and humane benefits of a plant-based diet. The Californian Senate earlier passed a bill discouraging drift nets in order to protect marine life and has unanimously voted for vegan meal options in prisons.
We heartily support your Earth and Health Protecting Resolution.
The Honorable Ash Kalra, and best wishes for it to pass with flying colors. Also, an enthusiastic round of applause, California, for leading the nation in the transition to an environmentally friendly and cruelty-free way of living. May all beings soon thrive in a kind and gentle world.
Free eye surgeries performed in Nigeria. Free cataract surgeries have been performed on at least 250 underprivileged people in Nigeria, thanks to the Ophthalmological Society of Nigeria, with medical supplies donated by Sightsavers, an international NGO. A cataract is the clouding of the lens in the eye, which decreases vision. Dr. Sunday Abu, chairman of Eye Camp and Surgery Committee of the Society, pointed out that cataracts are the most common cause of blindness in Nigeria and could be treated with surgery when diagnosed early. Further speaking of preventing blindness, Dr. Abu said, "We advise people from age 40 and above to have their eyes checked on time and at a regular basis to ascertain if there is any eye challenge. Our heartfelt thanks to the Ophthalmological Society of Nigeria and Sightsavers for safeguarding the vision of so many. May all the lovely souls of Nigeria prosper with robust health and abundant happiness." United Kingdom restricts sales of kittens and puppies. The UK government has passed Lucy's Law, which prohibits buying puppies and kittens under 6 months of age from pet shops, online dealers, and other third parties in England. The new law requires adopters to go to a rescue centre to find an animal companion. Lucy's Law is named after Lucy, a loving cavalier King Charles Spaniel, who was rescued from the inhumane conditions of a puppy farm and later passed away due to the injuries that she had sustained. Lucy's Law campaign was supported by various animal welfare groups, with a petition signed by nearly 150,000 people. Commenting on the new law, Environment Secretary the Right Honourable Michael Gove said to UK-based Sky News, "What we want to do is to try to make sure that anyone who has a pet will know that that puppy has been brought up in the right circumstances. We are elated by this good news, United Kingdom, and deeply thank you for your compassionate ruling. May lawmakers all over the world pass measures like this to ensure the safety and well-being of our treasured animal co-inhabitants."
Japan introduces robots to help improve classroom English. Starting in April 2019, Japan's Education Ministry will begin a pilot project in 500 schools nationwide to help boost children's English speaking skills.
In particular, artificial intelligent robots will help nurture the students' pronunciation and conversation skills in English.
Scheduled for full implementation in 2 years, the program will also include study apps and online sessions with native English speakers. Also, starting that year, all students will be required to learn English from the age of 10. The initiative comes ahead of the Tokyo Olympics in 2020, when an increase in tourists is expected. What a fun and intelligent way to encourage English learning. Good luck, Japan. May your high-tech endeavor be blessed with joy and success.